Hi everyone, hope you're having a good night. Today I'm going to be using the Shelee technique and make some earrings. So I got these earrings, are wooden. Round, they're probably, I don't know, 2 inches round, 2 inches across. So what I did is I already made a set. Still sort of drying. There you go. So it turned out pretty good. So I just painted the back black. I ended up using Winsor and Newton varnish spray to seal the front. I was gonna resin them, but then it's just such a mess to deal with on the back that I thought I would just do that. So they're still pretty shiny. So I'm going to do two sets. I'm going to use the same, well actually the blue is a little darker blue than I used on those. So I took the earring part out and I taped the back. And I sprayed some white to cover the dark, the wood. Gave it a sort of a prime coat. So let's get started. My recipe will be down below. This cell activator actually is 50-50, 50% US Floetrol recipe and 50% Australian Floetrol recipe. So I just mixed it up. That's what I used on the other ones. I'm going to be using, this is Grumbacher Turquoise Green with Totally Teal Color Cottage Pigments. If you can see that. This one is Chroma Orange with Golden Red Light and Clementine Pigments. Nice orange Folk Art Color Shift Green Flash and Green Flash. Really pretty. And this is Artist Loft Gold and 24 karat mixed. So those are the four colors I'm using. I'm using a black cell activator. These are pretty cool. I mean, you get these at the dollar store, these little containers, and these just wipe off with alcohol. So, I mean, they don't rub off too easy, but spraying with alcohol, they rub off, and then you can write the new paint color that you use on the top. That's just a little tip. So let's get started here. First, I'm going to be, anyway. Shelley with this technique is named after. I know she's selling earrings, but hers are her design, and then I think they're printed on earrings. So these will be like original. Each one will be different. So I'll probably have them in my Etsy shop. Different colors. I wasn't sure it was going to work being this small, but it does. So I'm going to pick this one up. I'm going to start tilting. All right, I have one little measle on there. That should be pretty easy to get off. think that's it. So there you go. That orange has outlined the black. Pretty cool. That measle will be easy to pop, one air bubble. Okay, this one, it looks like it's still gone down in the middle. So when these, as these are drying, I do cover all my, actually I cover all my paintings now, whether it be this technique or a regular pour, any resin pieces, any, I just cover it all. It slows down the drying, it helps with cracking. Next set, I think I'm going to just switch a few of the colors and see what we get. See if I can stretch it a little bit more. Yeah, I think I will try the sticks on the next set. Cool. There you go. What is that? No, I think I'm gonna have to go a little bit more on this one. Looks like it got some paint on there. There you go. Very cool. They do look like a match. This one might have a little bit more green. This one might have a little bit more blue. But it's still obvious that they're a pair. So I'm going to go ahead and try to put some sticks on the next set, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Don't know why I didn't think about this to begin with. My idea with the coasters and the stick, this is going to be much better too. So I just taped it on there, a smaller stick. Now on these, I could probably, on the coasters, I use the big sticks, the ones I get at Home Depot. These are the ones right here. They're a lot bigger than your normal sticks. So I wipe these off. I just twist them off, wipe them off so I can reuse them. These little ones, I'm not going to worry about it so much. I won't have to grab the edges. They're pretty level like they are, so I can just let them dry like that and then twist it off after, so I don't have to handle. On the coasters, I hold the back and twist. I might be able to do that, but I don't need to because I'm not going to save the sticks if they get messed up. So what I did is I took out the gold and I added a pink. This pink is Artist Loft Neon Pink. I'm going to have that as my first color. I got these on little shot glasses. So let's get started. The other ones turned out really good. I changed to little sticks in my paints too. I really, really like this size just all around. It just seems easier to see the consistency of your paints, how it flows off the stick. I really don't like using the little ones because it's hard for me to see the consistency. It's just, it doesn't flow off the stick the same to me. So, but because these are so small, I'm going to be using the little ones. Maybe a little easier to get off the stick. So let's get started. Oh, another tip would be to use a different straw for every earring that you do. Condensation builds up in the straw when you blow, and if you use it again, you're going to have spit, water, condensation, whatever you want to call it, coming out into your paint. So you just use another one. That shouldn't happen. Thank you. this one's really getting away here. That black sinks pretty fast. So I'm gonna work. Hope that's not too much. Where are you? So while you're watching me, if you could subscribe, push that notification bell, that helps me out. And go ahead and comment. Tell me what you think. Also, tell me where you're from. I'd like to see where my viewers live. I would appreciate it. I really like that orange and black. A few measles, but those are easy. Pretty color. I will grab those measles just after I do this one. This one's getting away. I don't know what's going on with that white area, but I might have to do this one over. I just don't understand. Let me put a little black on. Measles here, and then I'll bring you down for a close-up. All right, here they are. Here's the four I just made. Really pretty. Yeah, that orange and black is beautiful. This is the other one. Where is it? Right there. These are the ones with the pink in it, but the pink sort of disappeared. You can see it in there a little bit inside that blue. Look how pretty this one is. Wow, the cells are perfect in there. So anyway, at the end of the video, I'll probably have these put back together with the earrings and painted on the back, varnished on the front, and check it out. The recipe's also down in the description. Have a great night. Cheers. Please subscribe. Bye.